country, helping to pave the way for more women leaders across our state. From her time on the school board in St. Paul through her now 6 terms in Congress, she has worked tirelessly for the best interests of middle-class families. She has worked to ensure that all of our young people can receive a world-class education in Minnesota and that all Minnesotans can afford it. She is committed to making sure that all Americans have access to health care. She believes and leads from the conviction that all women should have the right and the ability to make their own decisions regarding their health care. She believes in planning for a future of clean American energy that powers American jobs. And her most recent claim is being the woman who forced Michelle Bachmann to move out of her home to run for Congress. It is my privilege to introduce a defender of the middle class and all Minnesotans, the Congresswoman representing the 4th District, Congresswoman Betty McCollum.
Good morning. Good morning. Let's give Governor Dayton a big thank you on three. One, two, three. Thank you. Well, I'm Betty McCollum. I'm that other Congresswoman. And it's my honor to represent the hardworking families of what is currently the 4th District, including Dakota County. And I am honored, to receive the DFL endorsement for re-election. Thank you to the new 4th Congressional District. Thank you. State delegates, the DFL endorsement matters. It matters for our candidates in Congress because it will put them on a path to victory. In this election, we need to pick up 25 Democratic seats to retake the majority in the U.S. House. DFLers, Minnesota has a job to do. In the 2nd District, you endorsed Mike Obermiller, and we now need to elect him to Congress. Mike! In the 3rd District, you endorsed Brian Barnes, and now we need to help elect Brian to Congress in November. And in the 6th District, you endorsed Jim Graves, and now we need to send Jim to Congress. And in the 8th, District, you endorsed a former member of Congress, Rick Nolan, and now it's time to return Rick to Congress. Well, we know we can't take anything for granted. Nothing can be taken for granted in this election cycle. So you all know that we need to work hard to make sure my 3 DFL brothers, Tim Walz, Keith Ellison, and Colin Peterson, are re-elected as well. And 2 years from now, we will be together to help re-elect my Senate brother, Al Franken. Now, I have to tell you the buzz in Washington. They're talking about Senator Klobuchar because she's bright, she's sharp, she works hard. They're saying she's already won the election. Well, we don't take anything for granted in Minnesota, and we all need to work hard to re-elect Senator Amy Klobuchar. We need her working for us in the U.S. Senate. Now, as Chairman Martin pointed out, redistricting gave us a new congressional map this year. This new map extends the 4th Congressional District into Washington County, putting my home in St. Paul in the same district as the home of the chairwoman of the Tea Party caucus in the House. Now, we know the saying about the American flag, these colors don't run. Well, the same thing can't be said for the Tea Party's flag. Their flag says, live free or die. Well, I guess the Tea Party caucus chairwoman saw the new map. She decided that running away from her home gave her a chance to live free versus the alternative if she remained in the 4th District. So, for Those of you who are currently living in the 4th District, represented by a former Tea Party candidate for president, you will be liberated. I need your help in order to do that on November 6th. Friends, for the past 3.5 years, our country has been digging out of the deepest, most painful mess experienced in 3 generations. 8 years of President Bush's and the Republicans in Congress got us into an economic disaster. For the past 3 years, President Obama has been leading us out of it. His leadership has saved millions of jobs, prevented millions of families from falling into poverty. He has put America on a path forward. And now we can see some light at the end of the tunnel. Jobs are being created, and the economy, although it's slowly starting to kind of build its energy back up. Well, since 2009, the Republicans in Congress and their corporate sugar daddies have been obstructing, stalling, and they have done everything in their power to stop President Obama's jobs agenda from moving forward and working. And we need to change that. We can change that. In order to defeat President Obama, can you imagine putting in these deep deficit cuts that the Republican Tea Party is talking about? It's going to cause more hardship and more pain on millions of Americans. In order to gain political advantage, the Tea Party Republican in Congress is willing to see America's credit rating damaged and our economy pushed into a brink of crisis. It is wrong. It is just wrong. The majority of Tea Party Republicans and their corporate billionaires are attempting to execute a hostile takeover of America, folks. They're willing to destroy our economy and millions of lives if that means defeating President Obama. Democrats, this country is at risk if the Tea Party Romney crowd wins this fall. Our Tea Party opponents are determined to expand tax breaks for millionaires and billionaires, paid for by eliminating services to the poor, the sick, and the most vulnerable in our communities. We don't need more penthouse protections. We need to protect the social safety net. Our opponents are willing to deny Americans the most basic element of the American dream, a job. And they're willing to do that to stop President Obama from succeeding. To me, this is beyond politics. It is a betrayal of America's promise. It is economic treachery. We must re-elect President Obama, stop Mitt Romney from turning America's corporate into a corporate state in which workers, seniors, and middle-class families are broken, bankrupt, and busted into pieces so Wall Street can profit, just like Romney did with Bain. Now, I'm going to work real hard to get myself reelected, my congressional brothers, Senator Klobuchar, and we are going to work in the 4th District to help take back the Minnesota House and Senate. So I'm asking you to join me in this fight. Our future for this country is on a line, and our future in the state is on the line as well. We need Democrats to rise to this challenge. I thank you. We need you. I thank you.